Tuesday. Okay, so the day is 15th and the day is Tuesday. So we'll start with maths first, and we have finished. You have finished doing number 17 in your maths activity book. Today you have to do 17 in your classwork books. Maths classwork book. Okay, so I'll show you on the board. In the same way, you have to write it in your maths classwork book. So you write the date 15-9-20. You write the heading and then you write 17. Then leave one box 1-7-17. Leave one box 1-7-17. 1-7-17. 17. Again leave one box 17. 17. 17. 17. In this way you have to write the full page of 17. Say and write when you're writing, children. Yeah, this is your maths classwork book and you have to write 17 in this, like I showed you on the board, right? Write the date, write the heading and 17. Then you leave one box 1-7-17, 17-17. In that way you have to write the full page, children. Write neatly and say and write 17. So you have to leave one box and then write 17 and say and write 17 1 7 17 in your maths classwork book. Yes. So now we have finished our maths. Now we come to English. Today we are going to learn a new letter P, capital P and small p. This is how it is. It's a capital P here and a small p. So let's see the pictures for the letter P. P for pot, P for parrot, P for peacock and P for pen. Again, P for pot, P for parrot, P for peacock and P for pen. So these are the letters with the pictures will start with the letter P. Now in P you have even pencil, you have what are the other things, penguin, so you have many pictures that you can see, the pictures that begin with the letter P. Okay, this is your English activity book. You have to open to page number 21. Yes, and write the date 15-9-20. Now you know, right, children, what you're supposed to do here. You have to tick the pictures which begin with the letter P, right? So P for parrot, P for pillow, P for pen, P for piano and P for pencil. So these are the pictures that begin with the letter P. Net doesn't belong to the letter, doesn't begin with the letter P. Okay, so it's only P for parrot, P for pillow, P for pen, P for piano and P for pencil. So these are the pictures you have to tick. How to write the letter P? From the red line to the blue line, standing line, red line to blue line, curve line, capital P. Again, red line to blue line, standing line, red line to blue line, curve line, capital P. Again I'll show you, red line to blue line, standing line, red line to blue line, curve line, capital P, standing line, curve line, capital P. So capital letter starts from the red line to blue line and the small letter will start from the blue line to red line, standing line, blue line to blue line, curve line, small p, blue line to red line, standing line, blue line to blue line, curve line. In these two blue lines you have to make the curve line, children. So that is your small p. Blue line to red line, standing line, blue line to blue line, curve line, small p, standing line, curve line, small p, capital P, small p, capital P, small p. Yes, now your English workbook, print capital and small letters. You have to write in that P. So you open to the page where you can see the P, right? Page number 49, write the date 15-9-20 and start writing your capital P. curve line, capital P. Red line to blue line, standing line. Curve line, capital P. Capital P. Capital P. Capital P. So it's capital letter, I told you before also. Capital letter will start from red line to blue line. Then you go to page number 50. And you write the date again. 15-9-20. And write your small p. Blue line to red line. Blue line to blue line. Small p. Blue line to red line, standing line. Blue line to blue line, curve line. Small p. Start from the blue line, children. Small p will start from the blue line. Small p. So you have to write the full page. Capital P, full page, and small p, full page. Page number 49 and 50. Finish your English and you finish your maths. Now you come to rhymes. Okay, so in the rhymes, already you have learned the rhyme, Five Little Soldiers. So come on, I'm going to try to do the actions. Okay, yeah. Five little soldiers standing in a row. Three stood straight and two stood so. Along came the captain, and what do you think? They all stood straight as quick as a wing. Did you enjoy it? I did enjoy it. I hope you enjoyed it. So once again I will say, five little soldiers standing in a row. Three stood straight and two stood so. Along came the captain, and what do you think? They all stood straight as quick as a wing. Yeah, so that is your rhyme. Today is the third day and we are explaining about this rhyme. So please learn the rhyme. The rhyme is your homework to learn it. Your English is your capital P and small p. Tick the pictures which begin with the letter P and 17. So these are all your homework, children. Please do your homework and post them on your WhatsApp group for your teachers to see and give you attendance. So take care, be careful, stay at home. Take care, bye.